Next on our tour of the eukaryotic cell is the endomembrane system. Now that we've learned about the administrative office, let's look at where stuff is made and how it's transported. We're going to look at the endomembrane system. One of the major components of the endomembrane system is the endoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum is the production line for our factory. This is where the stuff is made. And this endoplasmic reticulum, by appearance, it looks like interconnected tubes and flattened sacs of membrane material. So when I say membrane material, I'm talking about a phospholipid bilayer. The nucleus had a double membrane. The organelles of the endoplasmic material, they have a single membrane boundary. Now there are two general categories of endoplasmic reticulum. There's the rough ER and the smooth ER. The reason why they're given these names is because when scientists were first observing the cell with microscopes and discovering these organelles, one of the types of ER looked very rough, like sandpaper. It had a bunch of little things embedded on its surface. Well, it turns out that those things are ribosomes, and ribosomes are sites of protein synthesis. So if the rough ER is covered with ribosomes, we know proteins are being made there. Specifically, the types of proteins made at the rough ER are those proteins that will either be embedded within membranes or proteins that will be secreted from the cell. In contrast, the smooth ER does not have ribosomes, and so it's very smooth. If there are no ribosomes, what are being made there? Well, it turns out that lipids and membrane materials that will be needed by the cell, they are synthesized at the smooth ER. So phospholipids, cholesterols, and other types of membrane materials are formed at the smooth ER. So the rough and the smooth, they are both sites of synthesis. They both make stuff. The rough ER makes proteins since it's covered with ribosomes, whereas the smooth ER makes lipid material. The next organelle that I'd like to introduce you to, that's a part of the endomembrane system, are the transport vesicles. In fact, these transport vesicles, you can think of them as the forklifts of the cell. Their job is to move substances from one location to another within the cell. When we look at them, they look like they are bubbles or sacs of membrane material. These little bubbles are able to take materials from one organelle of the endomembrane system and transport them to another. In fact, that's really the defining characteristic of the endomembrane system. Endo refers to inside or internal, and membrane, talking about those phospholipid bilayers. So the endomembrane system is made up of membranous organelles. That both send and receive materials through transport vesicles. Another way in which these transport vesicles are like forklifts is that these transport vesicles are used exclusively for internal transportation. Just as a forklift might take something from one part of the factory to another part of the factory, but rarely would you see a forklift driving down the freeway or highway burying some of these materials. The transport vesicles are confined to the interior of the cell. Transport vesicles are formed when the walls of one of the organelles in the endomembrane system starts to bulge outward, collecting the material both within that organelle and also within the membrane of that organelle into an area. It forms a little pocket or bubble, and as that bubble seals, it separates from the original organelle and can transport to another organelle of the endomembrane system. When that transport vesicle fuses with the wall of that receiving organelle, it will empty the contents within the vesicle into the new organelle. Also, the membrane material that made up the transport vesicle will now become a part of the wall of that new organelle. The Golgi apparatus is another member of the endomembrane system. The Golgi apparatus, in a lot of ways, looks like the rough ER, but instead of making stuff, the Golgi apparatus is the shipping department. It's both receiving and sending materials and sorting them. The Golgi apparatus looks like a series of stacked, flattened membrane sacs. And the job of the Golgi apparatus is that it processes. The newly made proteins and lipids from the ER. It adds specific chemical tags or groups to these materials. In essence, you can think of them as address labels. It can then sort and organize these molecules based on those address labels, and it targets those molecules to their destinations. The Golgi apparatus receives vesicles from the ER and other members of the endomembrane system. It processes and sorts those materials and modifies those materials as needed, puts them into different transport vesicles, and sends them out to their destination. Another organelle of the endomembrane system are the lysosomes. Lysosomes are small spherical organelles. That in a lot of ways look just like any other transport vesicle. These lysosomes are assembled by the Golgi apparatus. Now, what makes them different from other transport vesicles is what's inside. These lysosomes contain digestive enzymes that are used to break down macromolecules. These enzymes can break carbohydrates down into simple sugars, can break proteins down into amino acids, and can break lipids down into their individual fatty acids. These enzymes are inherently dangerous to the cell because the cell is made up of macromolecules. If these enzymes were to just be free-floating within the cytoplasm, they could end up destroying the structures of the cell itself. But they play a very important role, and as long as they're safely contained, they can help the cell clear itself of damaged organelles, aid in the digestion of food particles, and also act as a defense force to help destroy invading bacteria. The lysosomes are sort of the cleanup crew, the janitorial staff of the cell, helping keep things neat and orderly, breaking down those things that need to be destroyed, but then also serving as an extra layer of defense. These lysosomes, they are unique to animal cells, and again, they're just found within the cytoplasm of those animal cells. The next group, also a part of the cleanup team, but in this case, they deal specifically with hazardous materials. They're the hazmat team. And they're called peroxisomes. These vesicles are made to contain and neutralize reactive toxic molecules known as free radicals. Free radicals are produced in our cells during energy production. If they're just allowed to stay in our cell, they could be damaging because they are highly reactive. And so what peroxisomes do is they actually neutralize these free radicals, and they use molecules to do that, and those molecules are called antioxidants. You may have heard of antioxidants as being something that we might get from foods or from supplements. Well, it turns out our cells produce antioxidants as well to help in our own defense. One of the last organelles that we're going to talk about in discussion of the endomembrane system is found only in plant cells, and that is the central vacuole. The primary function of the central vacuole is to store water cells for the plants, so that it can use that water when it needs to photosynthesize, and it can also use that water to give support and strength to the cell. So the central vacuole is a specialized structure in plants. It fills with water to provide rigidity to the plant, but also a supply of water to allow the plant to perform photosynthesis. That takes us to the end of our discussion of the endomembrane organelles. The next group of organelles that we'll talk about are the energy organelles, the mitochondria, and the chloroplasts. See you in the next video.